Hi all, I'm Ankur Gupta and welcome to Analytics School. As I had mentioned in the previous videos also, that companies store data in various file formats. CSV and Excel seems to be the most popular file format to store the data. In the previous session, we have already discussed in detail how to read CSV files in Pandas. In today's session, we will discuss in detail how to read Excel files like Pro using Pandas. Before we start doing example, let's install a Python package because Pandas can't read Excel file on its own. There are two Python packages that will do the job for us. One is XLRD and the other one is OpenPyXl. The package XLRD can open both Excel 2003 as well as Excel 2007 plus files, whereas OpenPyXl can open only Excel 2000 plus file, which has an extension of .xlsx. So these are the two Python packages. You can install either of them. We are going to read Tableau Superstore dataset. It has three sheets. One is orders, which is a typical shipment table. People, which has an information about the regional manager. And returns, which of the orders have been written. I'll be using this dataset to demonstrate how to read into Pandas data frame. And notice that the top row contains the header of the table, which will be used as a column names for the data frame. Now we will use Pandas read underscore Excel method to read Excel sheet into the Pandas data frame. By default, it will read the first sheet from the Excel files and parse the first row as a data frame column name. Let's do an example. First, let's import the necessary libraries. And we are going to read the superstore dataset as DF. Let's see the first few records. This is the plain vanilla way. You can see here the order ID, order date, ship mode, customer ID. The first row has been read as a column name and rest of the records are the observation. So this is the most basic way you can use read underscore method to read any Excel file. In the previous example, we learned that when no sheet is specified, Pandas will load first sheet in an Excel workbook. In our Excel file, we had three sheets, order, people, and return. Now let's say if we wanted to load the data from the sheet returns, we can use the parameter sheet underscore name equal to. This parameter, if specified, it will help us to load the sheet which we want. For example, in this particular case, returns. Let's write the code and see how we can load the data from the return sheet. So we are going to create a variable df underscore return and we will call the pandas read underscore excel method. Excel is, and then we pass sheet underscore name equal to parameter. And here we pass return. Let's check the first few records. Spelling mistake. So you can see here, we have successfully read the return sheet. Similarly, we can load a sheet name by its position too. Pandas will use the position of 0 to read the first sheet. Let's say if we want to load the data from the sheet return, we need to use position 2 to read return sheet. Let's see that. We can create another variable called df underscore ret and we will be calling, let me copy and paste this one. And in place of sheet name, we will pass 2. let's call the head method. And you can see the output is same. So you can use either label or the position of the sheet, and you can read that particular sheet from an Excel file using sheet underscore name parameter of read underscore Excel. Let's say there are 30 sheets in an Excel file and you want to read all those 30 sheets at once. In that particular case, one needs to use sheet underscore name parameter and has to pass none as the value. Then all sheets will be read. Let's see that. Df underscore all. As we know that in superstore dataset, we have 3 sheets. What I'm going to do is, I'll use the sheet underscore name parameter and pass none. Now, the interesting thing is, let me write type. In this particular case, df underscore all is a dictionary. And if you want to read a particular sheet, we need to use the sheet name as key. What does it mean is, if we want to read order sheet, we need to pass orders as a key. And you can see here, this is an orders dataset. And we can pass to a variable called orders, and then we can use it. Let's say if we want to read returns, we are creating a returns variable df underscore all and passing here returns as a key. Let's see few records. So by using sheet underscore name equal to none, we can read all sheets of an Excel file at once. There may be a time when you do not want to read each and every column from an Excel file. In order to do this, we can use the use calls equal to parameter. It's a very flexible parameter that lets you specify a list of column names, a string of Excel column ranges, a list of integers specifying the columns to load. Most commonly, you will encounter people using a list of the column names to read in. Let's load our superstore dataset, and this time we are going to read only customer, sales, and profit variables. Let's do it. Df underscore SEL. Superstore. .xls. We are going to use calls parameter, and then we will pass a list. By the way, you have to be very careful about the column name. It is case sensitive. Sales profit customer ID. Df underscore SCL dot head. Let's use the head method to see the first few records. Now you can see here, by using use calls parameter, we have read only selected columns. They are customer ID, sales, and profit. Read underscore Excel method in Pandas make it easy to specify the data type of different columns when reading an Excel file. This mainly serves three main purposes. One, preventing data from reading incorrectly, speed up the read operation, and saving memory. One can pass in a dictionary where the keys are the columns and the values are the data types. This ensures that the data are read correctly. Let's see how we can specify the data type for our columns. Let's pass superstore dataset. And we will be using D type parameter. Let's say for customer ID, we want to read it as an sales as float. And ship date as a date field, date time field. Let's run the code. Oh, spelling mistake. Let's use the info method and see whether we have read customer ID, sales, and ship date correctly or not. For example, customer ID should be object, sales float, and ship date as date time 64. So ship date has been read as a date time 64, sales as float, and customer ID as an object. The cool thing about this method is that you do not need to pass the data type for all the columns for this to work. When reading large Excel file, it can be helpful to read only a small subset of the data first. This allows you to quickly load the file to explore the different columns and the data type. This can be done using the nRows parameter, which accepts an integer value of the number of the rows you want to read into your data frame. Let's see that. Df underscore subset pd.read underscore Excel superstore.xls, and we are going to use the parameter nRows. Let's say we want to read only first 20 records. Let's use the shape method to see how many records have been read. You can see there are 20 rows and 20 columns which have been read. So this particular data set has 9994 records, and by using nRows parameter we have read only 20 records out of 9994. So today we have learned Pandas read underscore Excel method and its various parameters in pretty much in detail. This method not only support XLS and XLSX file extension, it also support XLSM, XLSB, ODF, ODS and ODT file extension to read it from a local file system or URL. So guys, that's it for today. See you next time.